The Motown Museum's 6th annual Motown Mic, the spoken word, has officially kicked off. Now, every Friday, poets perform original pieces for a chance to move on to the grand finale and win prizes. And this morning, I'd like to welcome Raina Baker, the program manager for the Motown Museum, and Mike Phelps, last year's winner. Thank you guys so much for joining us this morning. Raina, tell us a little bit about Motown Mic. What is it, and what would people experience if they come check it out?
So through our programming at the museum, we're always interested in inspiring the next generation of. That can be musicians, it can be business owners, but it also includes poets. And so Motown Mic is our way of paying homage to Motown's Black Forum label. It was active in the early 70s, and it served as a platform for expression and education. And so this program is a continuation of that legacy.
And we have last year's winner here, Mike Phelps. Tell us a little bit, Mike, about the piece you perform to win, and tell us a little bit about what it's like being crowned the champ.
Well, one, it's just been great being the champ, learning so much about Motown, getting to meet a lot of the different people who are instrumental in keeping that legacy alive. Mm-hmm. As far as the poem, it was a poem that was kind of hard for me to write, because once I started to do the research on Motown, I realized I didn't know as much as I did, as I thought I did about Motown. So writing that piece, it was just a way for me to be able to research Motown, get to know the music more in the behind the scenes, and that kind of helped me out and just being able to go forward with, you know, the partnership with Motown. So,
and Raina, where did this idea come from? I understand, you know, the purpose of it, but when people think of Motown, they think of music. Mm-hmm. Obviously, you mentioned there are different labels. Who sparked this idea?
So our chairwoman and CEO, Robin Terry, along with the co-producers, Osiris and Sparrow, who are poets in the community, mm-hmm. they came up with this brainchild, and every year we just water the seed. Obviously, it's in honor of Black Forum, but it also goes to speak on this narrative that Motown is more than music, and poetry and songwriting go hand in hand.
Absolutely. I mean, the best songwriting is poetic.
Exactly.
In its expression. And Mike, tell us a little bit about advice. If there's someone sitting at home going, you know, I think, you know, I have what it takes, I want to try. Do you have any advice for either young poets or people who might want to compete this year in Motown Mic?
Speak up, you know, just go out to a competition, one of the ones, the preliminaries, and just speak up. It could be about anything. Poetry is not limited to, you know, the things that we think they're limited to. You can say whatever you like, you can express yourself in whatever fashion you like to. And so I think if you go down and you just speak from the heart, that's what I did, that's what every other poet who's won has done, I think you'll be fine.
You know? How long have you been writing poetry?
Since about 1987, and that was the year I was born. So.
Okay, so his whole life has been poetic. Yeah. All right, well, I'm told that you actually can perform a little bit of your performance from last year.
Yes.
Please, take it away. Ladies and gentlemen, Mike Phelps.
Neighborhoods gentrified, gotta watch out for smiling faces sometimes, because they want you to be too proud to beg, but you don't beg, do you? Because your papa was a rolling stone on cloud 9 with a shotgun, and he didn't take any four-letter words. And your mom, she raised you sweet with Diana Ross smiles and the Supremes in her teeth. You was raised in Motown, even if you weren't raised in Motown. And that's why y'all think I'm still talking about a label like it wasn't a church, like Smokey Robinson wasn't a choir director with the whole congregation behind him. And they tell me that Motown is starting to come back. And my reply is, we've never left.
Mike Phelps, thank you so much. I love the imagery of the that you created there. And as we wrap up, Raina, how can people participate, and how can people come check out the poets, even if they don't want to step up to the mic and compete with someone as talented as Mike Phelps? How can people just watch?
So join us at the museum every Friday this month from 8 to 10. Doors open at 7:30. You can purchase tickets online or at the door. And what's special about this year is that we've opened the competition up to those 16 and older. So right, whether you're a poet, a musician, if you want to do comedy, it's a family-friendly space, so come on down.
Raina Phelps, thank you so much for joining us. I'm sorry, Raina Baker, forgive me, Mike Phelps. Thank you so much for joining us. Mike's got me twisted with all these poetic words. I really do appreciate it. Let's